a beautiful world. And the most wonderful aspect of this world is that everything in it seems to be continuously undergoing some change. Some of the changes we notice, while others we do not notice. Some of the changes that we saw took a long time to happen, while others, like bursting of crackers, are fast changes that happened almost instantaneously. Oh, this is a photograph of my grandfather. This must be really very long ago. And in this picture, he has changed so much in so many years. It is a slow but a sure change. Incidentally, aging is not only a slow but also an irreversible change. Though everybody wishes that it wasn't so. Trees do grow, but they grow very slowly. These rocks will change. They will wither, but you hardly notice it. Some of the changes are so slow that they take millions of years to happen. For example, formation of fossil fuels. Changes may happen anywhere. Come with me in the kitchen. I'm going to make my breakfast. While I'm busy there, you may observe the changes that are happening in the kitchen. I'm busy. You observe me. Did you notice that? All these represent changes. Striking of matchstick, burning of gas, melting of butter, breaking of eggs, and finally the cooking. Do you know, curd gets made from milk. A small amount of curd called starter is added to the lukewarm milk and is kept aside. What has happened? The bacteria present in the starter changes the milk to curd. This is obviously a slow but a useful change. Now tell me, is it possible to get back milk from curd? Definitely not. Can we get back fresh egg yolk from the cooked eggs? Of course not. These changes cannot be reversed. Such changes are called irreversible changes. Oh, this too is an irreversible change. Hey, with a trick, we have made this reversible. But in reality, this is irreversible. But some changes are reversible. Water is a special substance. We can easily change this water into ice. The ice melts into water again. This ice changing from solid to liquid. Now let us see how liquid water changes into gaseous state. Water is boiling and changing into water vapor. We can reverse the reaction and get back water from the vapor. Water can change from one state to the other easily, and these can be reversed. Such changes are called reversible changes. What kind of a change is this? This too is a reversible change. Look, these have got rusted. This has happened after a long time. So rusting is also a slow and an irreversible change. Each of these plants has taken a long time to grow. Can you believe that this beautiful butterfly was once an ugly caterpillar? This caterpillar too has undergone a slow and irreversible change. Changes that happen in seasons are also slow. They follow a regular pattern. Such changes are called periodic changes because they repeat themselves. Sunrise and sunset are cyclic in nature. Day and night follow each other closely. We have seen so many changes happening. Is there some similarity in all these changes? In all the changes, you might have noticed that some property of a substance undergoes a change. Let us see if we can change the physical state of wax from solid to liquid. The wax changes to a liquid form when we heat it. The moment it touches water, it cools down and changes back to solid state. Does water, wax or butter change into a new substance on cooling or heating? No, it does not. Water is still water and so is the wax. So the material changes only its form or shape but does not change into a different kind of material. Look at the paper. It has only changed in form and shape, but it still remains the same material, paper, is called a physical change. What do you think happens to salt and sugar when they are put in water? Sugar has dissolved in water and it tastes sweet, but it has not changed into something else because it still tastes the same. Sugar and salt are dissolved in water and they remain the same material. The change that takes place in them is a physical change. Now let us see if we can change the properties of sugar in another way. When the sugar is heated excessively, it changes into something entirely different. Sugar was white in color, but this new substance is black. It does not taste sweet. In fact, it is bitter. This kind of a change is called a chemical change. Now, I am burning this paper.
This is a new substance and has no resemblance to the paper we had burnt. This new material has characteristics that are different from the characteristics of the paper. This kind of a change is called a chemical change.
Chemical changes can be seen all around us.
In autumn, when the leaves turn from green to yellow to orange, a chemical change is taking place in the leaves.
Every time we burn a matchstick, we burn the chemicals at the end of the matchstick. A black splinter is left behind. Is it possible to use this again to get fire? No, it's not, because the burnt splinter is very different from the match we burnt. All the changes that we noticed were fast or slow, reversible or irreversible, periodic or non-periodic. These can also be categorized as physical and chemical changes.
Physical changes. Chemical changes.
Physical changes are sometimes called temporary changes. This is true in the case of rubber band and spring, because they regain their original shape on release. But this is not true in all the cases. Similarly, we cannot get back this chalk with which we started to this reduced size.
Note, the nature of the substance remains the same. Breaking of a glass tumbler, tearing of paper are also physical changes in which the substance do not get back to their original form. So all physical changes need not necessarily be temporary or reversible. Let us consider some more examples. Is chapati making from dough a physical or a chemical change? Yes, a chemical change.
Because baking causes chemical change to the dough, it is tasty.
Consider this. The toothpaste remains the same whether it is inside or pushed outside. It is a physical change. It is a fast change and is irreversible by nature. This is a chemical process because wax has changed to just carbon. It is a fast and an irreversible change.
Let me tell you, our body is like a chemical factory, and all the time chemical changes are taking place. Whatever we eat every day changes into energy for our body.
Pickling, a process used for preservation, is a slow and an irreversible change. We have seen that breaking of eggs is a physical process and frying it is a chemical reaction. Now, what do you think happens when the egg is boiled? It is a chemical change and it is also an irreversible change. The cleansing action of soaps and detergents is also a chemical reaction. The soap combines with grease and dirt and changes into a new substance. This new substance gets easily washed away by water. Did you notice that as the soap is used, it used to decrease in size? The soap reduces only in size but undergoes no change in properties. Is this a physical or a chemical change? Yes, it's a physical change, which is irreversible by nature. I believe pencil and eraser we use in school which decrease in size? This ripening of banana is a chemical process because inside it changes a part of it into sugars. Remember, when a material changes its shape or size but does not change into a new material, then we say that the physical change has taken place. If a material changes to a new material, then we can say that a chemical change has taken place.
Now, you cannot only observe the changes occurring around, but also classify them. Discuss it with your friends. And if you find an interesting change which we have not thought about, then please write to us. Our address is Tarang, Post Bag No. 40, Horse Khas, New Delhi, 110016.